One of the big benefits of living in this block is having classical music beautifully played morning and afternoon. In fact, I know people who have been used to standing outside the building in the street listening to her and just admiring her playing. And she still plays every day.
To the residents of this small apartment building in North London, Alice Summer is simply the lady in number six.
My world is music. I am not interested in anything else.
She has her health, her friends, and her music. And at 106, she feels she's one of the luckiest people alive. Alice receives visitors every afternoon, people who come to hear her stories and maybe learn from her experience.
I love people. I love everyone. I love people. I love to speak with them. I'm interested in the life of other people.
Alice is the oldest Holocaust survivor in the world.
Beethoven. He is a miracle. His music is not only melody, what is inside. How it's filled, it's full, it's intensive. Phenomenal.
In 1942, Alice was a well-known concert pianist living in Prague. At age 39, she was deported to a Nazi concentration camp. Theresienstadt was a purgatory for artists. Designed by the Nazis to deceive the international community, its purpose was to show the world how well the Jews of Europe were being treated by their Nazi captors. Under constant threat of extermination, starving prisoners were permitted to paint, to perform, and make music. For propaganda purposes, Theresienstadt was the only camp in which children were not taken from their parents. Alice had been deported with her little boy, Rafi.
I knew that we will play, and I was thinking, when we can play, it can't be so terrible. The music, the music. Ah, here they are.
Ah, so how is it going?
This is my very good Sunday friend. She comes every Sunday.
Alice's friends, Zdenka and Anita, are also Holocaust survivors. And like Alice, music was essential to their survival in the camps.
But every day in life is beautiful. Every day. That we are here, we can speak about everything. Not? It's beautiful.
In Theresienstadt, Alice gave more than 100 concerts, performing all of Chopin's etudes from memory.
That was my first time, actually, I have had all Chopin's etudes. And I remember Alice sitting on the stage. I was in about third row and saw her from the right profile. And I was quite captivated. It was magic to hear this music in that kind of surrounding, which you don't realize until it's over. So you come sort of back to earth and see where you are and how much it was a moral support. It was not entertainment, as most people think, that we were having fun. It had a much bigger value.
I felt that this is the only thing which helps me to have hope. It is sort of religion, actually. Music is God. In difficult times, you feel it, especially when you are suffering.
Alice's faith and inspiration was passed on to her son Rafi, who sang in Theresienstadt's children's opera, Brundibar. Alice's undiminished optimism gave him strength, and he too survived.
We are sleeping on a mattress. He felt my body. When a child is near to the mother, everything can happen. He is not afraid. He gives him a security. And I was always laughing. Even there I was laughing.
So the people who were sitting in the audience, we were transported into a different time. The time before when we lived in a normal civilized life, civilized world, and hoping and being convinced that the war will soon finish, and we'll go back home and it will go on. But of course, what we knew later, the Germans knew full well that we are sentenced to death, and thought, let them play, let them laugh. The laughter will soon vanish from their face. And we were dancing under the gallows.
Sometimes it happens that I am thankful to have been there because this gave me I am richer than other people. My reaction on life, it's quite another one. All the complaint, this is terrible, it's not so terrible.
My father always used to say the very wise words, put as much as you can into your heads, because that's something nobody can take away from you. And I think that is so very, very true. And I think this is where music comes in, the importance of music, because you can actually have music in your head without anybody knowing it is happening. You can actually go into another world, which is a lot nicer than the world we're actually living in. I can say without hesitation that the cello saved my life, because I knew what was going on in Auschwitz. So I arrived in Auschwitz really preparing to go in the gas chamber. I mean, that was Auschwitz, it was gas chambers. Instead of that, when I arrived there, it's a sort of ceremony, you know, people take your clothes off you and shave your head and tattoo a number on your arm. And this is all done by prisoners. And one of these said, what's going on? How long is the war going? Will it soon be over? You know, sort of question. And what's your name and where do you come from? And what did you do before you were arrested? And like an idiot, I said, I used to play the cello. I mean, you know, really ridiculous thing to say. And she said, oh, fantastic. You'll be saved. So I became a member of this orchestra, which was a completely life-saving, because as long as they wanted music, they couldn't put us in the gas chamber. I mean, you know, there's a certain amount of logic in the Germans.
A lot of German journalists come and want to know, speak with me and so on. Before they enter my room, they ask, are we allowed to enter your room? Do you not hate us? So my answer is, I never hate and I will never hate. Hatred brings only hatred.
Alice Sommer has lived her life without hatred. Nourished by the unquenchable power of music, she remains a beacon of hope and inspiration to everyone who knows her.
I was born with a very, very good optimism. And this helps you. When you are optimistic, when you are not complaining, when you look at the good side of our life, everybody loves you. Only when we are so old, only we are aware of the beauty of life.